continue topic of the gymnosperms, which was stopped in part 1. In this video, continuous topic of the internal characters, nothing but anatomical characters of the gymnosperms. In this anatomical characters, we are going to discuss about the anatomical structures of the root, anatomical structure of the stem, as well as anatomical structure of the leaf. Okay, then in this root internal structure, before going into this topic, I want to give one clear explanation about the xylem arrangement. Xylem arrangement in the internal structures of the root, stem and leaves. First of all, xylem. Xylem and phloem are fused together, formed as a bundle-like structure. The term is known as a vesicular bundle. Vesicular bundle defines which parts are used for the transportation, either water transportation, mineral nutrients or food transportation. Such type of parts are combined together, formed as a compound structure. Bundle-like structure is known as vesicular bundles. We have to observe these vesicular bundles in the internal structure of the whatever that part, either root, stem and leaves. We have to observe these vesicular bundles. Before going into these internal characters of the vegetative body, I want to give the explain of these terms. In vesicular bundles, both xylem and phloem are present. Xylem containing the two types of the xylem, those are the protoxylem and metaxylem. See these pictures. Protoxylem and metaxylem. In the xylem, two types of the xylems are present. Those are the protoxylem and metaxylem. Protoxylem cells are smaller in size. Which xylem is formed at first time? Okay, protoxylem. Proto means first. Which xylem is formed first time? The xylem is known as protoxylem. In this xylem, vessels are smaller in size. Such type of xylem is known as protoxylem. And metaxylem. Meta means lost. Which xylem is formed later? The formation of the protoxylem is known as metaxylem. In this metaxylem, cells are larger in size. See these pictures. Based on the arrangement of the protoxylem in the vesicular bundles, based on the arrangement of the protoxylem in the xylem, position is in different ways. Those are the exarch, endarch and mesarch position. These pictures are showing, explaining about the xylem position. Those are the exarch, endarch and mesarch position. Remind one thing, one information. Whatever the plants commonly in the internal structure of the root, xylem position is exarch. In the stem, xylem position is endarch. In the leaf, xylem position is mesarch. This is the technique. This is the tip of the reminder of the xylem position in the root, stem and leaf internal structures. And also, what is mean by exarch, endarch and mesarch? Already I said protoxylem, metaxylem. About the protoxylem and metaxylem. Yes. In this exarch position, protoxylem is towards the outer side. Such type of xylem position is known as exarch. Already I said protoxylem. In this protoxylem, cells are smaller in size. Okay. In this exarch position, this is the exarch condition. Smaller cells are towards the outer side. This is the exarch. Exit. Exarch means outer side. Okay. This is the exarch. I mean, protoxylem is located towards the outer region, known as exarch position. Protoxylem is arranged towards the inner side, is known as endarch position. And mesarch means middle region of the xylem. Protoxylem is known as, that condition is known as mesarch. This is about the clear explanation of these terms, exarch, endarch and mesarch. Then, normal in gymnosperms internal structures of the root. When we will cut into the transverse section of the root, commonly, whatever that pods, either root, stem or leaf, majorly three pods are occurs. Those are the epidermis, cortex and central cylinder. Nothing but vesicular bundles. Okay. These three pods are absorbed in the root, stem and leaves, whatever that pod. But instead of the cortex, cortex only present in the root and stem only. But in leaf internal structure, there is no cortex. Instead of the cortex, in leaf internal structure, mesophyll is present. Mesophyll is present. But in root and stem internal structures, three pods. Those are the epidermis, cortex and central cylinder. Nothing but vesicular bundles. Okay. These pods are absorbed in the TS of the root and stem. Okay. In this gymnosperm root, epidermis, cortex and central cylinder is present. Epidermis as well as in this root internal structure. This is the root internal structure here. This is pinus root TS, pinus root transverse section or internal structure. In this root consisting the epidermis and epidermis. Okay. But which roots are producing of the hairs, root hairs, those are known as epiblema or piliferous layer. Okay. Then outer layer is epidermis or epiblema. Inner side of this layer, and in between, that means in between the outer layer and inner layer, cortex, parenchymatous tissue is present here. And inner side of this cortex, endodermis are here. Okay. Then going into the central region of the gymnosperms are known as central cylinder, vesicular bundles. These vesicular bundles, these are the vesicular bundles. Already I said, I explained about the what is vesicular bundles. Means both xylem and phloem are combined together formed as a bundle like structure. That is the vesicular bundles. But in gymnosperms, vesicular, in gymnosperms root internal structure, vesicular bundles, xylem and phloem are separate. Okay. See this picture here. This is the clear diagram of the radial type of the vesicular bundles. What do you mean by radial type of vesicular bundles? Here, xylem and phloem. Both xylem and phloem's arrangement is in a single radial row. This is the xylem, this is the phloem. These are arrangement is in single radial row. This type of vesicular bundles are known as radial vesicular bundles. And one more important point is here. In this gymnosperms, opposite to the protoxylem arms, opposite to the protoxylems, specialized structures are here. These are the specialized structures are present opposite of the protoxylem arms. Those are known as resin canals or resin ducts. These resin ducts are used for the producing of the resin, which are used in the turpentine industries. Okay. Then this is about the complete information of the root internal structure. Already I said xylem and phloem are arranged on same radial row, and steel is diarch or triarch position, rarely tetrarch in position. Xylem position is exarch. Okay. Here steel is in diarch or triarch position, rarely tetrarch position. I said here xylem number is equal to the phloem number, phloem number is equal to the xylem number. Here which type of xylem, I mean triarch, diarch or tetrarch? See this picture. These are the diarch position, two numbering of the xylem, two numbering of the phloem. So this is the example of the diarch condition of xylem. In this way we have to observe the triarch condition and also tetrarch, rarely tetrarch, four in numbering of the xylem and phloems. Okay. And also then secondary growth also occurs in the gymnosperms root internal structure. This secondary growth is similar as dicotyledonic plants. Okay, this is about the complete information belongs to the root internal structure gymnosperms. Then going to the stem internal structure. In the stem internal structure, this is the stem. Stem TS, pinna stem TS, for example. I'll take one example, that is the pinna stem internal structure. Similarly, as root, three major parts. Those are the epidermis, cortex and stellar region, central cylinder. Okay. This is the epidermis, cortex and central cylinder. Nothing but vesicular bundles. But in this xylem, position is endarch position. Yes. In this stem internal structure, vesicular bundles. In root internal structure, there is no formation of the bundles. Separately arrangement of the xylem and phloem. Yes, but in the stem internal structure, we have to observe the vesicular bundles. Okay. These vesicular bundles are 5 to 8 or 9 in numbering of the vesicular bundles. In U-steel arrangement, U-steel arrangement means whatever the numbering of the vesicular bundles, those vesicular bundles are arranged in a circular, like this. These are the circular in arrangement. This type of arrangement is known as a U-steel arrangement. Okay, so in this gymnosperms, vesicular bundles are 5 to 8 or 9 in number and in circular arrangement. U-steel antonym is atactostyle. Atactostyle means vesicular bundles are zigzag in arrangement. There is no particular certain manner. Okay. Then, in this vesicular bundles type, these vesicular bundles are conjoint, collateral, open and endarch type of vesicular bundles. See here. These are the vesicular bundles. Conjoint means in the vesicular bundles, both xylem and phloem are in a single bundle. Inner side of the pod is xylem, outer side of the pod is phloem. These are the conjoint. Okay, combined, conjoint and collateral, beside region. And open, in between the xylem and phloem, a separation line is here. This separation line is known as a meristematic cambium or cambium. Okay, this is cambium. Okay, which vesicular bundles are containing the separation line of cambium? The such type of vesicular bundles are known as open. Which vesicular bundles do not containing the cambium? Such type of vesicular bundles are known as closed. Okay, but in this we have to observe the cambium. So these are open type of the vesicular bundles. Okay, completely in this vesicular bundle, which type of vesicular bundle? Conjoint, collateral, open and endarch position of the vesicular bundles are occurred in the stem internal structure of the gymnosperms. Okay. In every vesicular bundles, some elements or some components are present, xylem and phloem. Under the xylem, these components are occurs commonly in xylem, tracheids nothing but cells of the xylem cells are known as tracheids with barrier pits, xylem parenchyma and xylem vessels. In phloem, components, sieve tubes, phloem parenchyma, companion cells and albuminous cells. Okay, commonly these are the components present in the xylem and phloem. But in gymnosperms, xylem containing only tracheids, xylem parenchyma. There is no xylem vessels in the gymnosperms. I mean, xylem vessels are absent in the gymnosperms. This is the noted point. Okay, but only in natal. These xylem vessels are present only in natal's order. Commonly, these xylem vessels are absent in the gymnosperms. But in natal's order, xylem vessels are present. Okay? These are the components under the xylem. Then, in phloem, components, sieve tubes and phloem parenchyma is present. But companion cells are absent in the gymnosperms. Instead of these companion cells, albuminous cells are present. Okay, these are the important points in the gymnosperms. Then, in stem also showing the secondary growth similar as the dicotyledon plants like root. But in this gymnosperm, secondary growth containing the significance, one important significance here. Secondary growth is similar as dicotyledon plants. After the completion of the secondary growth, secondary xylem is formed towards the inner side, secondary phloem towards the outer side. After completion of the secondary growth, secondary xylem is formed, secondary tissues are formed. Yes, in the secondary tissue, secondary xylem and secondary phloem are formed. Secondary xylem towards the inner side, secondary phloem towards the outer side. Okay. And the secondary xylem, which is located towards the inner side, and the secondary xylem, two types of the woods are present. Those are the early wood and also late wood. Early wood also known as summer wood, late wood also known, early wood also known as spring wood, late wood also known as autumn wood or summer wood. Okay. These are the two types of the woods which are located on the secondary xylem. See this picture. In this picture, spring wood, summer wood are here. Spring wood, nothing but early wood. Autumn wood, nothing but late wood. What do you mean by early wood? What do you mean by late wood? Already in this term, early wood. Early wood means in wood structure, which wood is formed at early stage. Such type of wood is known as early wood, nothing but spring wood. Okay, which wood is formed later? I mean, later the formation of the early wood, the such type of wood is known as late wood. Here, early wood is formed when leaves, new leaves or new branches are formed at the duration early wood is formed. And also at the time, nutrients and water is requirement for the development, for the maturation of the new leaves and new branches. So, in this condition, cells are actively participated. Cells are actively in condition. Okay. Late wood is completely opposed to the early wood. Late wood is formed when the fall of, leaves and branches, at that time late wood is formed. And also there is no requirement of the water and nutrients. So in this late wood, cells are inactive. This is the minute differentiation in between the spring wood and autumn wood. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the differentiation in between the early wood and late wood. Here, early wood and late wood, nothing but spring wood and autumn wood. In this differentiation, four points are noted. Those are the which time wood is formed in which time. Second point is track its size, either larger in size or smaller in size. And lumen, intercellular spaces are either broad or linear in size. As well as, if brackets are larger in size, the cell wall is thin. If brackets are smaller in size, the cell wall is thick. Okay, these are the four points to be noted before going into this differentiation of the spring and autumn wood. Already I said about the where is the form, when is the formation of the spring and autumn wood. Yes, spring wood is formed at spring season. That means, when new leaves and new branches are formed, at that time spring wood is formed. Okay. And at this condition, active transportation of the water and nutrients are required in the spring wood. Okay. In the autumn wood is produced at the cool weather. Autumn wood is produced at the cool weather where the leaves fall. And so, active transportation of the water and nutrients are not required. Okay, this is the when wood is formed. This is the first point. Then going to the tracheid size, xylem cell size. Xylem cells are, tracheids are larger in size in the spring wood because water and nutrient requirement is active. Okay, this requirement is more in quantity, that's why tracheids are larger in size, but in this cells are inactive, so tracheids are smaller in size. When tracheids are larger in size, cell wall is automatically thin. Okay, when tracheids are smaller in size, cell wall is thick. Okay, then lumen is broad in the spring wood, lumen is narrow in the autumn wood. This is the clear explanation about the differentiation in between the spring and the autumn wood. Okay, then in a tree or in a plant, both autumn wood and also spring woods are formed in a year and forming an annual ring. I mean, in a plant or in a tree, one spring wood and one autumn wood compound in structure one ring of the autumn wood, one ring of the spring wood. Both are combined together, formed as an annual ring. That is indicate as one year, indicate as a year, completion of an year. Okay, so in this way we can be calculated the plant age through this annual ring. Okay, one see the picture here. This is the summer wood, this is the spring wood. Yes, okay, in this way this is the summer wood, this is the spring wood. Both are, this is one, this is one. Through this calculation we have to calculate the plant age. Okay, study about the plant age is known as dendrochronology. Study about the plant age is known as dendrochronology. Okay, then along with this autumn wood and spring wood, in this after completion of the secondary growth in the stem, we have to observe the two types of the xylems or two types of the wood is formed. Those are the monoxylic wood and pycnoxylic wood. See the below pictures. These are the monoxylic wood, these are the pycnoxylic wood. Monoxylic wood, mono means larger size of the cells. Cells are larger in size. Automatically, when cells are larger in size, cell wall is thin. When cells are smaller in size, cell wall is thick. Okay, this is monoxylic wood, it is pycnoxylic wood. Differentiation in between the monoxylic and pycnoxylic. In this monoxylic, cells are larger in size. In this, cells are smaller in size. Cuticle layer, nothing but cell wall is thin. Here, cell wall is thick. Then, monoxylic cells are larger in size. Yes, in this, xylem parenchyma is more in numbering. That means parenchyma. Parenchyma is more in numbering. That's why medullary rays are broad. Parenchyma is more in number, so broad medullary rays are present in the monoxylic. In this pycnoxylic, xylem parenchyma is absent. There is no xylem parenchyma in the pycnoxylic, so medullary rays are linear. Medullary rays are linear in size. Due to this reason, that means in the monoxylic wood, xylem parenchyma is more in quantity. So, this wood is very soft. Okay. But in pycnoxylic, there is no medullary rays. If medullary rays are present, those are the linear in size, and also there is no xylem parenchyma in the pycnoxylic. Parenchyma means soft in nature. There is no parenchyma in the pycnoxylic. That's why this pycnoxylic wood is used for commercial value. This wood is used for the commercial valuable timber. It's very hard. It yields a commercially valuable timber. This is clear in detail explanation of the differentiation in between the monoxylic and pycnoxylic wood. Okay. Monoxylic wood example is cycadales order. Technoxylic example is coniferous order. Okay, here one note is here. Absence of the xylem vessels in the xylem and companion cells in the phloem. This is the commonly this nature is belongs to the endophytic nature, but it also present in the gymnosperms. What is the xylem vessels are absent except of the lytes part. Okay, and also companion cells also absent in the xylem. These two characters are belongs to the pteridophytes, but we observed in the gymnosperms also. Okay, this is the complete information of the stem internal structure of gymnosperms. Then one more TS, transverse section, are anatomical characters of the vegetative body, that is the lost anatomical characters here. This is leaf anatomical character. In this leaf, mesar type of vesicular bundles are present, and mesophyll. Commonly, mesophyll is nothing but in between the epidermis and the vesicular bundles. Mesophyll, parenchymatous mesophyll is present. Commonly, mesophyll is differentiated into the two parts. Those are the palisade parenchyma and sponge parenchyma. Okay. In leaf tears, in pinus leaf tears, some important parts are absorbed. Those are the armored parenchyma and transfusion tissue and sunken stomata. Commonly, this armored parenchyma also known as plaquette parenchyma. This armored parenchyma and transfusion tissues presents in pteridophytes, fawn plants. Which plants are fawns in the pteridophytes? In that fawns, we have to absorb the armored parenchyma and transfusion tissue. But these two parts are absorbed in the pinus leaf tears. Along with these two characters, these two parts, another part also specialized, that is the sunken stomata. The sunken stomata is characteristic of the xerophytic members. Okay. This is the haplocalyx stomata. Here, this is stomata. Around the stomata, this is stomata. Around the stomata, these are the guard cells, two in numbering. Around these guard cells, these are the subsidiary cells. These subsidiary cells and also guard cells are originated from the different mother cells. That is known as haplocalyx stomata. Okay, then going to the synodocalyx, in this single mother cell, from the single mother cell, both type of the guard and subsidiary cells are originated. Okay. These are the terms about the two types of the stomata origination. Okay, then this is the leaf anatomy of the gymnosperms. For example, I'll take the pinus leaf. I want to show about the leaf internal structure clear with clear explanation. I'll take the pinus needle internal structure. Needle nothing but pinus foliar leaves. Pinus has two types. Pinus have the two types of the leaves. Yes, those are the foliar leaves and also scale leaves. Yes, foliar leaves are in needle structure. That's why these foliar leaves also known as the needle. This is the pinus needle internal structure. Observe here, in this pinus leaf internal structure, I mean gymnosperms leaf internal structure, three pods are present. Those are the epidermis, mesophyll and vesicular bundles. Instead of the cortex, in leaf internal structure, mesophyll is present. Yes, in this, it is outer layer, epidermis. In between the outer and inner layer, mesophyll is present. Commonly, mesophyll is showing the differentiation, that is the sponge tissue and also palisade tissue. But in this internal structure, in this anatomical characters, there is no differentiation of the sponge and palisade tissue. One, see this diagram here. In this, this greenery pot, which is present in between the inner layer and outer layer, this is known as the mesophyll. We have to observe the specialized characters in the pinus leaf internal structure. I already explained before the topic. Those structures are armed parenchyma. Armed parenchyma and transfusion tissue as well as sunken stomata. In this picture, we clearly observe in this image, those are the here, these are the sunken stomata. Okay, these are the sunken stomata. This sunken stomata character is present in common xerophytic nature. But this nature is occurs in the pilous leaf internal structure. Okay, then another special characters mesophyll. In this anatomy, mesophyll is containing the specialized character, that is armed parenchyma. Armed parenchyma means armed, armed parenchyma. Here, this is the armed parenchyma. Armed parenchyma. Arm means armed parenchyma. This armed parenchyma also known as plicate parenchyma. What do you mean of armed parenchyma? Armed parenchyma. In this mesophyll cells, inner side of the cells, inner layers of the cells are enfolding towards the inside, formed as a finger-like structure, formed as a knob-like structure, or formed as a finger-like structure. That's why this parenchyma is known as armed parenchyma. Entire mesophyll is made up with the parenchymatous tissue only, and inside of the walls of cells are folding, infolding towards the inner side. That's why this is known as armored parenchyma or plicate parenchyma. Due to the presence of this armored parenchyma or plicate parenchyma, one advantage is here, that is photosynthesis is higher. Photosynthesis, wide space is present here. That's why photosynthesis is most advantage to this in this mesophyll tissue. Okay, then going to the internal part, this is the vesicular bundles. In this endodermis and pericycle, xylem, phloem, entire these topics are observed, entire these parts are observed in inner side of the internal structure. Okay, in this another important part also present in this here, this is transfusion tissue. Here, transfusion tissue is present here. This is the transfusion tissue. Okay? This is about the complete explanation of the leaf anatomical characters. And in this gymnosperms, leaves exhibit the xerophytic characters. Some xerophytic characters, those are the thick cuticle layer, sunken stomata, sclerenchymatous tissue, and transfusion tissue present in the pilous leaves, and hypodermis layer with sclerenchyma. Hypodermis layer means in this below region of the epidermis, 2 to 3 layers or 2 to 5 layers of the sclerenchymatous tissue is present. This is made up with hypo sclerenchymatous tissue. It is known as hypodermis. Okay. This is also one character of xerophytic, sunken stomata, thick cuticle layer, sunken stomata, hypodermis layer, and transfusion tissue, and also these are the xerophytic features. Okay, this is the second part of the gymnosperms, which are explaining about the internal characters, nothing but anatomical characters of the gymnosperms pods. Gymnosperms, vegetative pods, those, they are the root, stem, and leaves. Thank you.